Hello and welcome to In Depth. I'm Tina Jha. Today on the show, we talk about the world's largest aircraft that took its first flight on 13th April. Built by Stratolaunch Systems Corp, the carbon-composite airplane is called Rock. The plane is a behemoth with a twin fuselage, 28 wheels, 6 747 jet engines, and a wingspan longer than an American football field, end zones included. It has been designed to carry rockets to an altitude of 35,000 feet, at which time they would ignite and launch into orbit. During the test flight that lasted more than 2 hours, the plane reached an altitude of 17,000 feet and a top speed of 189 meters per hour. What is the role of innovations like these in the aviation industry? How do they change the shape and the direction of the industry? And did similar inventions in the past have any significance at all? We find out in depth today. The twin fuselage six engine with a wingspan broader than a football pitch made its first test flight on 13th April in California. Built by Stratolaunch, the company claimed it is the world's largest plane. The aircraft is designed to act as a flying launch pad for satellites. Here is a detailed report. On 13th April, the world's largest aircraft took off over the Mojave Desert in California in the United States. Built by Stratolaunch, the company set up by the late Microsoft co-founder Paul Allen in 2011, the aircraft is designed to act as a flying launch pad for a satellite. The white airplane called Rock has a wingspan broader than a football field and is powered by six engines on a twin fuselage. After taking off, the aircraft stayed in flight for more than 2 hours before landing safely back at the Mojave Air and Space Corps. The dual fuselage Stratolaunch is designed to fly to an altitude of 35,000 feet, where it can drop rockets that ignite their engines and boost themselves into orbit around the planet.
On Saturday, April 13th, the world's largest plane, having a wingspan of 117 meters, flew over the California Mojave Desert, creating history and a record in many ways. So, the main idea of the plane is not just commercial transport, but it's actually meant for launching satellites in orbit. So, to get into the technical specifications or what is it the flight about, the flight flew for 2.5 hours, and it is done by a company called Stratolaunch. And interestingly, the company was originally founded by Microsoft co-founder Paul Allen, and now he's passed away, but he is the one who founded this company with a view to do the satellite launches. I mean, we have seen several other US entrepreneurs coming in to launch their own satellites and low Earth orbit. So this is actually falls in that line. And this is the first test. And by 2022, they intend to get operations ready and start launching satellites into low Earth orbit.
Stratolaunch seeks to cash in on higher demand in the coming years for vessels that can put satellites in orbit. It is competing in the United States with other space entrepreneurs such as Elon Musk's SpaceX and United Launch Alliance, a partnership between Boeing and Lockheed Martin. There was no rocket on the first flight on 13th April, but the company has already signed at least one customer, Northrop Grumman, which plans to use Stratolaunch to send its Pegasus XL rocket into space. The company says the idea is to lower the cost of space flight and make launching a satellite as easy as booking an airline flight. The Stratolaunch is still in development and is due to start operating in 2020. The business also has plans to launch a small space plane capable of carrying a number of passengers, but that is yet to be determined. With inputs from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
The aviation sector is experiencing rapid growth worldwide, propelled by booming tourism industries, lower airfares, and the push for greater connectivity in an increasingly globalized economy. Middle-class expansion has also spurred growth in air travel, as more people are able to afford flights for holidays or business-related travel. The space industry is also emerging as one of the most lucrative industries globally.
Growth of aviation in emerging economies has provided jobs to millions of people. Presently, the global aviation industry is on a high growth trajectory. Today, the global airline industry consists of over 2,000 airlines operating more than 23,000 aircrafts, providing services to over 3,700 airports. Global passenger traffic is also growing faster. The International Air Transport Association is expecting 6% revenue growth above the 5.5% long-term trend. Rising fares coupled with continuing low fuel cost and low interest rates are expected. The world's commercial fleet, which is currently estimated at approximately 25,000 in-service aircraft, is forecast to expand to 35,000 over the next decade.
In the last few years, there has been some positive development, and it is a feasible proposition, and it can be done, yes. And so when we come to the public good, and how does it benefit the public, or in terms of commercial endeavors, how does it benefit? Here the benefit is because, again, as I said, one, the cost goes down, because of which more companies will start using satellites, which will improve their services, say, telecommunications, TV, and see, nowadays satellites are used for everything. For a small weather prediction, not just a Met department, but even a company which is into the business of weather predictions or things like that. For instance, even Amazon is using satellites, and Apple, for instance, has satellites of their own, but it's a big company which can afford to do it, to improve their services, accuracy, precision, professionalism in many ways. So now more and more companies can actually go for smaller satellites or utilize satellite services to improve their services and efficiency.
Similar is the trend for the global space industry, that is projected to grow at 5.6% and valued at $558 billion by 2026. Demand for nanosatellites and reusable launch vehicle systems is anticipated to be driven by the massive investment by countries like US, China, Russia, and the European Union in the development of next generation satellite systems. In terms of categories, nanosatellites segment is anticipated to account for one of the largest share of expenditure globally. The fastest growing market from 2024 onwards will be the China, as the Chinese government continues to make billions of dollars of investment in this industry.
To add to that, bringing in the aspect of the airlines industry. So there is actually traditional airlines. There is a difference, and it's actually a very slight balance which happens. I mean, if you see our airlines, as we were discussing, we have seen Jet Airways going in bad shape and on the verge of literally closing down now. But this is where probably a bigger companies, airlines, can at some point venture into the space business, space tourism, which will actually make them more viable. Because commercial aviation or civil aviation has been going through a bit of churn in the last several years across the world, not just in India. And companies are struggling with reducing margins, increasing operational costs, but at the same time, the numbers are increasing. So this is where space tourism and space launches probably can give an alternate diversification option for airlines, bigger airlines, as we go forward.
And finally, the airliner of the future. Already in the works, it will see electric propulsion play a major role. Smaller electric motors will enable distributed propulsion like the one found in NASA's X-57 prototype. Lower noise levels and operational cost will make it possible for electrical powered aircraft to fly much closer to where people live and work. It could even make flying taxis a reality very soon. Making it possible are operating lesser investors who are providing the flexibility that air carriers demand. In 2015, 33 such companies with assets more than $1 billion and 5 with assets worth $10 billion provided such facility. Today, they number over 50 companies with assets in excess of $10 billion. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Innovations in any industry mark a quantum shift in the way things are done. They also indicate tremendous improvements in the comfort level for the users of its products. But these innovations are also accompanied by rapid technological disruptions.
It is the same with the aviation industry as well, which is on the verge of seeing some spectacular breakthroughs and big changes.
Globally, air travel is undergoing great change, and believe it or not, rapid innovation is emerging as one of its main challenges. Potentially, game-changing innovations are promising to transform our flying experience totally. In an age of rapidly escalating fuel prices, electric power is being touted as the next big revolution. Electric aviation, as it is being called, may not be too far away. In 2014, Airbus exhibited a two-seat all-electric e-fan demonstrator aircraft powered by two electric motors. In 2015, the e-fan crossed the English Channel. In 2017, a startup company, Zunum, announced plans to put into service a 12-passenger hybrid electric prop plane by 2022.
Well, internationally, if you see, most of the new technological developments are picked up by the private promoters, and all these ideas come as innovative ideas, and once they become commercially successful, they are very they are the breakthrough technologies. So I think it's a futuristic vision of the people who look ahead. So and they are not scared of investing resources, and that is where the new technology has evolved world over. So I think it is the individual initiative which takes you to places, and then it finds application for the masses and the common man. Particularly, it may have a lot more application for defense applications also.
Biofuels are another alternative to present-day aviation fuel. Biofuels have the advantage of cutting down on greenhouse emissions. Many airlines have already operated commercial flights using biofuels. Examples include United, KLM and Singapore. These biofuels are based on everything from recycled vegetable oil to plant-based ethanol. Virgin Atlantic is even developing biofuel using waste gases captured from steel mills.
But the way the hypersonic technology is evolving, the day is not far where for common usage some of the activities of this aircraft can be put to use. The new areas which are being discussed are the areas of space tourism, when people would be able to go to space and come back to their destination. So this all development is a futuristic development. To what extent it converts into commercial application is yet to be seen. It's a very exciting time for the industry.
In addition to eco-friendly air travel, the hypersonic jet holds out the promise of high-speed flights. In 2014, Airbus patented as hypersonic jet capable of reaching 4.5 times the speed of sound. The design shows an aircraft powered by the combination of turbojet, ramjet and rocket motor. Boeing officials expect hypersonic commercial flights to be a reality within the next decade or two. With faster flights, there is also the prospect of better entertainment. Much of it is already a reality. Smart devices are streaming entertainment through free high-speed internet along with free in-flight texting on board. Driverless public transport, pilotless flights is another innovation that is expected to lead to major cost savings. The industry is expected to save as much as $30 billion by adopting autonomous flight technology. Dubai and United Arab Emirates are already testing pilotless flying taxis for short distance flights. In countries like China, biometrics and facial recognition technology is replacing paper or electronic boarding passes. Facial recognition systems are deployed at 557 security channels at 62 airports in China. All passengers will have to do is stand in front of a camera and take a picture. Delta Airlines is experimenting with facial recognition for its automated baggage system. The company is also working on fingerprint recognition for its automated check-in program. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
The attempts to create giant flying machines go back several decades, with many countries and even private players developing such aircraft for both strategic and commercial purposes. As the Stratolaunch spreads its giant wings, we take a look at the giant aircraft that have dominated the skies in the past as well. Many of them are in service even now.
The Hughes H-4 Hercules was designed during the Second World War in response to America's long-range heavy transport needs. The giant flying boat made of wood and fitted with 8 engines took its first and only flight on 2nd November 1947, making the Spruce Goose to be considered the largest wingspan aircraft that has ever flown. Its only prototype is currently on display at the Evergreen Aviation and Space Museum in McMinnville, Oregon in the United States. The empty weight of Spruce Goose was 1,13,399 kilograms. It had a length of 66.65 meters and a wingspan of 97.54 meters. The six-engine Antonov An-225 holds the title of being the heaviest aircraft ever built and having the largest wingspan open aircraft currently in service. It is a strategic airlift cargo aircraft that was designed by the Antonov Design Bureau in the Soviet Union during the 1980s. The lone An-225 ever built took its first flight in 1988. Antonov Airlines makes the aircraft available for unique heavy lift jobs all across the world. It has an empty weight of 2,85,000 kilograms. It is 84 meters long and has a wingspan of 88.4 meters. Airbus A380-800 is the world's largest passenger airliner manufactured by Airbus. It took its first flight in April 2005. The double-decker A380 was designed as an answer to the increasing congestion of major hub airports. The full-length double-deck aircraft has a typical seating capacity of 525, though it is certified for up to 853 passengers. Currently, the Dubai-based Emirates is its largest operator. The operating empty weight of Airbus A380-800 is around 2,77,000 kilograms. It is 72.72 meters long and has a wingspan of 79.75 meters. Since its entry into service in early 1970 and for over 30 decades, the Boeing 747 has been the undisputed queen of the skies. While the Airbus A380 has a larger passenger capacity, the Boeing 747-8 keeps its place in the record books as the longest airliner in the world. It has an operating empty weight of 2,20,128 kilograms. At a length of 76.3 meters, it remains the longest aircraft in the world. It has a wingspan of 68.4 meters. The Lockheed C-5 Galaxy is among the largest military aircraft in the world. Built by Lockheed, it took its first flight in June 1968. It provides the United States Air Force with a heavy intercontinental range strategic airlift capability. It can airlift 6 Apache gunship helicopters or 2 M1 main battle tanks over distances of around 11,000 kilometers. The C-5 Galaxy has an empty weight of 1,72,371 kilograms and a length of 75.31 meters. It has a wingspan of 67.89 meters. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
While the dream of flying is probably as old as mankind itself, the concept of the airplane has only been around for 2 centuries. Before that, men and women tried to navigate the air by imitating the birds. In our next report, we take a look at the history of aviation and the airplanes.
The history of aviation extends for more than 2,000 years from the earliest forms of aviation such as kites and attempts at tower jumping to supersonic and hypersonic flight by powered heavier-than-air jets. Beginning in 1783, a few aeronauts made daring, uncontrolled flights in lighter-than-air balloons filled with either hot air or hydrogen gas, but the idea did not succeed. In 1799, Sir George Cayley, a baronet in Yorkshire, defined the forces of lift and drag and presented the first scientific design for a fixed-wing aircraft. Building on his pioneering work in aeronautics, scientists and engineers began designing and testing airplanes. In 1849, a young boy made the first manned flight in a glider designed by Cayley. In 1894, Sir Hiram Maxim, an American-born British inventor, made a successful takeoff in a biplane called the Test Rig. Test Rig weighed about 7,000 pounds and had two steam engines. Since the device was intended to be a test vehicle, it was held to a track, preventing it from rising more than a couple of feet. Inspired by Sir Hiram Maxim's success, Wilbur and Orville Wright experimented with aerodynamic surfaces to control an airplane in flight. Their work led them to make the first controlled, sustained and powered flights on December 17, 1903 in Kitty Hawk, North Carolina. The Wright brothers' accomplishments proved to be a wake-up call for many aeronautical scientists and engineers in America and Europe to the possibilities of fixed-wing aviation. The period from 1903 to 1914 is called the Pioneer Era in aviation, as this period saw the development of practical aeroplanes and airships and their early application for private, sport and military use. Almost as soon as they were invented, airplanes were used for military purposes. The first country to use them for military purposes was Italy, whose aircraft made bombing and artillery correction flights in Libya during the Italian-Turkish War from September 1911 to October 1912. The first war to see major use of airplanes in offensive, defensive, and reconnaissance capabilities was World War I. The years between World War I and World War II saw great advancements in aircraft technology. Airplanes evolved from low-powered biplanes made from wood and fabric to sleek, high-powered monoplanes made of aluminum. World War II saw a great increase in the pace of development and production of aircraft and associated flight-based weapon delivery systems. The first jet aircraft to fly was the Heinkel HE-178, flown by Eric Warsitz in 1939, followed by the world's first operational jet aircraft, the ME-262, in July 1942, and the world's first jet-powered bomber, the Arado AR-234, in June 1943. Helicopters also saw rapid development in the Second World War with the introduction of the Fokker Achilles FA-223, the Flettner FL-282 Synchropter in 1941 in Germany, and the Sikorsky R-4 in 1942 in the USA. By the end of World War II, many towns and cities had built their own airports. Civil aviation experienced rapid growth during this period as military aircraft were repurposed as airliners or personal planes. USSR's Aerofloat became the first airline in the world to operate sustained regular jet services starting on September 15, 1956. In 1957, Soviet Union launched Sputnik 1, the first artificial Earth satellite, into space. 12 years later, in 1969, Apollo 11 landed the first two people, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin, on the moon. The same year, Boeing unveiled the Boeing 747, which was the largest commercial passenger aircraft ever to fly and still carries millions of passengers each year. With the emphasis during the modern era on adopting digital techniques, the aviation industry has really taken off. In 1986, Dick Rutan and Jena Yeager flew an aircraft, the Rutan Voyager, around the world, unrefueled and without landing. In 1999, Bertrand Piccard became the first person to circle the Earth in a balloon. Countless aviation developments are currently ongoing with the goal of providing safer, faster and more comfortable air travel. At present, the aviation market can be classified under two categories: civil aviation and military aviation. While the civil aviation market is expected to grow at a compound annual growth rate of 0.72% during 2018 to 2023, the global military transport aircraft market is anticipated to grow at 0.6% during the forecast period of 2019 to 2024 and is expected to reach a value of $25 billion by 2024. The space industry is also emerging as one of the most lucrative industries globally. Valued at $360 billion in 2018, it is projected to grow at a rate of 5.6% to value at $558 billion by 2026. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
So that's it from us in today's edition of In Depth. You can also watch it online on YouTube and Twitter. And don't forget to send your feedback and suggestions about our program. Thank you very much for your time.